Okay, what you're looking at is a 24-inch pre-stressed concrete cylinder pipe. This is the L design. From this video, you can see our anchor system off to the spigot. You can see a repair done to a cylinder in the middle. On the left side, you can see the pre-stressing wire and our anchor system. And also notice the 1-inch thick mortar coating. And obviously notice the cylinder, how pristine the cylinder looks, which is provided by the corrosion protection is provided by the mortar coating. The next pipe over, this is their bar wrap pipe, AWWAC301, a bar wrap pipe. What you notice here is a mortar coating. The flange is the ability with bar wrap to add a flange in the field. Notice this is rod and not pre-stressing wire. Okay, we'll go around to the other side. This also is a 24-inch LCP bar wrap pipe. It shows our harness clamp style joint restraint. And you notice off to the right, this is the ability to take a piece of bar wrap pipe, literally cut it in half, and sleeve a flange in the field. Butt strap it. This is a process that can be done in one single day.
The difference between Hanson pipe and the lock joint pipe, can you explain the differences?
There's many differences from quality.
Okay.
What everybody talks about today, obviously, is the interface pipe.
Yes, the interface, right.
Of the 70s.
78 to 84, you had lots of failures with mm-hmm. that, with that pipe. Is that correct?
I would probably say 74 was a vintage year for interface failures.
Okay.
But a couple of the key differences today.
Okay.
One is the pre-stressing wire that we use today.
And the pre-stressing wire is this?
Well, not this particular. This is bar wrap.
Right, I understand. But this is the wire on pre-stress is, it looks like this.
Correct. Yeah, the wire we use today is a 6-3 wire.
Right.
The issues with the interface was the old class 4 wire, which hasn't been used since the early 80s.
Yes, right. Very interesting. I knew that there was numerous changes in the industry because of that.
Yeah, there's quite a few changes.
And I did this, I guess this is how the evolution of Hanson occurred, correct?
Correct.
Because of the interface problems.
Well, after interface, then it was Price Brothers Company.
Yes.
A legacy company from Price Brothers. It was purchased by Hanson.
Right.
Which is we're currently owned by Hanson.
Right.
What you see here is a tapping saddle. This would be a repair. Or if you wanted to, this is a 6-inch tap that's done on a 24-inch pipe.
Okay, how long would it take to make a tap like this on
your
pipe?
One day. Yeah.
Because most of these lines are transmission mains, so they're going to have very few taps on them to begin with.
Correct.
Because the T's are all going to be installed as on the lane schedule when the pipe is installed, correct?
Correct. Back in the late 70s, early 80s, a lot of pre-stress was made, but without these outlets, somewhat as engineering has involved, what you'll see is we do more outlets. We put more outlets on pipe in the event that at a later time it'd be easy to connect.
Right.
So you don't have to tap as much today, I would say, as you used to, because we kind of think ahead and put these outlets on prior to shipment.
I really appreciate it. Thank you.
You're welcome.
Thank you.